Hi, this is the Arcus 3D C1 end effector version 4.2. It is seriously dark. I can't believe how well the dyeing of this nylon worked. Anyway, so here's what I did that's different. First of all, I changed the fan mount, and instead of there's a bunch of them. My original design didn't have anywhere to, I realized I'm going to create a whole lot of wash over the hot end. So I redesigned this so it has a little slot there right next to the end. And there's still some water in there. I'll be washing them off. And then this fits in that little slot, and then this is actually a piece of TPU, but I had it on there already when I dyed it, and it took the dye just as well, so I'm really happy about that. That's white TPU, now basically black. So I did the same thing I did with the nylon for attaching that. I just put it against the soldering iron, mushroom the end out. So that makes that really simple, and it's actually pretty strong. So that lets me just do this, so I can get up, whatever I need to here when I'm not printing. And that just snaps on there. So let me give you a good view there. Roughly. Yeah, everything turned out just beautiful. I'm really happy. So my there's my new moving this up. I had to flip the fan over because it wouldn't fit the other way. I mean, it comes on it like that. Obviously, that doesn't work anymore. So I flipped the fan over, and ta-da! I hope that doesn't get too hot. But if it does, I'll just put a piece of aluminum tape there, and I'll probably be fine. So. Made these hinges a little wider because broke with one of them off. I printed, I annealed it. I annealed everything. Yeah, I'll have that in the same article here. And everything got a lot harder. Like all the plastic got a lot harder. And it's supposed to, prevent layer separation too, but all I can tell you is this stuff is really hard now. So it's basically perfect for what I needed here. I mean, that is as hard as I can push. And I can feel or see no deflection whatsoever. So pulling my lines will be pulling up here, and my middle will be pushing down here. And I think it's going to last, at least as long as the lines do. So that's good. Here's my way of leveling now. So the lines are going to come through the hole, go here. Yeah, that's a little problem, but work around that. Go around this screw like 5 times, and then goes to the other hole. And hopefully that means when I turn the screw, the line wraps up here and unwraps there, which will end up, leveling my end effector. I don't know. It may work, it may not. We're going to find out. If it doesn't work, I'll just turn the screw all the way in, and it'll hold it there. So it's going to work either way. It's just, will it work the way I want it to? I don't know. Got to get it all back together and get it printing. Oh, I ordered some this stuff, which is 110-pound test. It's a little bit more, the surface is rougher. It's still Teflon coated, but there's a definite braid to it, as opposed to the last stuff is basically like they waxed it or something, so it's like smooth when you do this. This has a definite braid to it. Anyway, I'll post a new video when it's all back together.